Hi again. I'm Alexandros Kostopoulos, Business Development Manager at CSR Hellas, and today I have the pleasure to have a brief talk with Dr. Pavlos Vlachos, Associate Professor in Marketing at ALBA Graduate Business School at the American College of Greece. Hi, Pavlos.
Hey, Alexander. Thank you so much. It's my pleasure to participate in this podcast, in this series of podcasts. Looking forward to discussing.
We will have the pleasure to host Pavlos in the CSR School 2021 in day 5th, which is 29th of June. And the focus of your lecture, Pavlos, would be the responsibility and sustainability-driven marketing. Reading the title, in recent years, we have seen the gradual transition of various business and function to sustainability. Given that sustainability is now the dominant current, where is the marketing itself in terms of the transition? Can we talk about sustainable or responsible marketing in terms of tools, methodological approaches, and application models?
Well, good question. Alexandre, I'm afraid we are not there yet. Although there are many, many traditional marketing tools available that can and should be adapted to facilitate transition to stakeholder capitalism. I will demonstrate those tools using novel primary data in the upcoming ESG school, as we have been discussing together in the past. For example, I will be discussing interactive positioning maps, conjoint analytics, segmentation analytics, all, of course, adapted to accommodate firms' sustainability agenda. These are traditional marketing tools. So marketing can really help towards a transition towards stakeholder capitalism. Indeed, I strongly believe that transitioning towards stakeholder capitalism is one of the most pressing and difficult managerial and scholarly problems of the 21st century. And this difficulty, this hard, very hard task, it is my strong conviction that requires, Alexandre, marketing to be broadened. And this is a key suggestion that I will be making in the ESG school. Marketing mm-hmm. should be broadened and reframed mm-hmm. for the needs of transitioning towards stakeholder capitalism. And to do so, it needs to be reframed along three pillars. Allow me to clarify if you're good with that. The first pillar is that marketing scope should be broadened to encompass not only consumer satisfaction, a key marketing metric, and consumer rights, but critically accommodate and encompass the notion of stakeholder satisfaction and stakeholders' rights. The second pillar is that marketing should not only monitor progress towards stakeholder capitalism, it should do that by measuring not only consumer satisfaction, but critically stakeholder satisfaction. Three,
right.
Marketing should build on the psychology of CSR so as to report and communicate progress towards stakeholder capitalism. And this is critical in a manner that will avoid accusations of greenwashing. That being said, again, it is my strong conviction, Alexandre, that marketing, many people will disagree with me here, but again, I may be biased. Still, I think that marketing is the best suited function to take up the challenge of moving towards stakeholder capitalism. Why? This is because marketers, I include sales representatives and salespeople here in the broader definition of marketing. Marketers have and will always be boundary spanners. Boundary spanners. This is important. Boundary spanners that can rely human resources departments, finance departments, accounting, legal, and IT towards the common purpose of ESG agenda and stakeholder capitalism. Again, marketers are by definition, and I mean that, interdisciplinary, allow me the term, beasts. that understand social psychology, understand finance, understand communication, and all are desperately needed. This interdisciplinarity is desperately needed in order to move towards stakeholder capitalism. Allow me a last comment on this very important first question of yours. Marketers have started working hard towards sustainable marketing. There are special issues in academia. Just recently, a special issue has been published in the Journal of Marketing named Better Marketing for a Better World. Very strong issue with really great articles.
Mm-hmm.
So people are, marketers are trying hard towards sustainable marketing. Why? Again, increasingly, an increasingly larger portion of consumers expect that brands should no longer stand only behind great products, you know, quality and the like, but also behind great values. For example, I'm sure you have heard, and most of our audience, people in our audience have heard, that more and more brands engage in what people call brand or corporate political activism. Brand activism, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure you remember Nike's position as an activist for racial equality, or the pledge made by more than 500 firms to join the Facebook Stop Hate for Profit ad boycott. Besides brand activism, marketers have also started to focus on topics like environmental product innovation, you know, eco designs, mm-hmm. dematerialization, and the like. And also, besides environmental product innovation, they have started focusing more on product responsibility, including, for example, customer privacy protection, health, safety issues, especially during COVID. Unfortunately, and concluding my first comment, is that some firms greenwash with respect to those two categories, as we find in recent research. Good news is that we also find a decrease in product greenwashing in the past 6 years. So things are getting better. But again, as I said earlier in my answer, we are not that there yet, but I am quite optimistic.
So thanks, Pavlo. So need to reframe marketing. And CSR related practices are indeed often seen as greenwash. Are there any approaches that help to remove this perception and ultimately strengthen the marketing itself as a business tool that help to convey the right message of corporate responsibility and sustainability?
Okay, this is again, as I said in my previous comment, greenwashing is important, and thank you for this question. Well, again, firms and brands should carefully communicate and invest in ESG, in CSR, in a manner that will reduce accusations of hypocrisy. The question is, technically, how can we do that? You know, people do not really trust business. So business is stereotyped. No matter what we do, no matter what firms do, they will be people that will accuse firms of hypocrisy. However, based on a recent paper that we published in a top journal in the field named Human Relations, quite recently, 2021, we find that firms that A, engage and communicate consistently across time, their CSR engagement, that is consistent engagement across time. They do so across many causes, not material, but many causes across many, many so-called moral or ESG domains. And critically, C, do so in a manner that is different from competitors, i.e., namely, the firms should innovate, because innovation and differentiation signals to audiences that the firm is trying, is putting effort. And effort is always something that signals authenticity and values. So these three things together, I believe, help firms communicate and invest towards more authentic corporate social responsibility and ESG. So there are tools. We can do that in terms of communication, but critically investing too. Okay.
Right. So let's move now to another very, very serious issue, let's say, regarding marketing, We see lately that brands position themselves on ethical or social dilemmas. Do consumers prefer such an approach? You mentioned just before business activism. Are consumers finally ready to reciprocate it with their purchase choice?
Okay, this is a very good question, and I would like to clarify this issue, and I will clarify that in my session at the ESG school. The answer is that there is a segment, I'm emphasizing this, a segment of consumers or employees or investors or the like, not all consumers, not all employees. There is a segment of consumers. You know, segmentation is a key marketing concept. You know, in marketing, people say that if you're not thinking segmentation, you are not thinking. So the answer, again, is that there is a segment of consumers, a segment of employees and the like that are ready to reciprocate. Not everyone. Usually, based on research, it is 3 out of 10, 4 out of 10 that are more likely to reciprocate. So firms aspiring to do well by doing good should use traditional marketing tools like segmentation analytics and conjoint analytics to more scientifically approach their CSR engagement and answer similar questions like the one that you posed, Alexandre. In other words, it is my recommendation to firms that have those sorts of questions to use CSR stakeholder analytics. Again, according to recent research, about 31 of respondents are putting planet and society first.
Right. Right. Thank you, Pavlos, indeed.
My pleasure,
extremely Alexander. Valuable, extremely valuable. And for those who are attending, if you would like to understand and analyze the role of marketing analytics tools like positioning maps in helping firms differentiate from competition and broadly compete on ESG performance, then this session is dedicated for you. Thanks again, Pavlos. Can't wait to speak to you on 29th of June in our session within CSR School 2021. Thanks again.
Thank you, Alexandre. Thank you. My pleasure. Looking forward.
Bye-bye.